I thank you, Jesus. God, thank you, Jesus. I thank you, Jesus. God, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise his holy name. Hallelujah. Thank God. Hallelujah. He will destroy every yoke. It is a breaker. It said destroy him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And in the mindset, glory to God, of warfare, glory to God, you're not out to break your enemy. You have to destroy him. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. We're not wrestling, as we learned last Sunday, we're not wrestling against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers and rulers of darkness and spiritual wickedness in high places. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So put on the whole armor of God,
yes,
that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, from the very beginning of January 1st, 2012, from the very beginning, amen, we've not relented. Not one single bit.
Amen.
A house of purity, a house of prayer, a house of power, and a house of perfected praise. Amen. We haven't relented not one single bit from the peas. Amen. Hallelujah. We are still. Hallelujah. He said, my house. He first came in and cleaned his house out. And then he said, my house shall be called a house of prayer of all nations. And I want to thank you all that join in on Wednesday nights for prayer.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. First Saturday morning for prayer.
Amen.
Amen. Glory to God. His house.
Yes.
I'm not talking about my house. I'm talking about his house. Shall be called a house of prayer.
Hallelujah.
Of how many nations?
All nations.
All nations. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. He said men should always pray and not faint. His house is a house of prayer, a house of power, and a house of perfected praise. And we're teaching on praise, amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. You know, the keys, the kingdom is opened up by keys. Amen. And one of the keys, not the only key, but one of the keys is praise. Amen. And as we're teaching on this series on praise, amen, we're looking into what praise is. And then we're looking at what praise does. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Come step up. Where your leg at? You mean your leg came with you when you walked up here? In other words, you don't come somewhere, your leg get there 15 minutes later. Amen. When you get God, you get all of him.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. He doesn't leave part of him over here and another part, hallelujah, over there. Glory to God. When you get God, you get him whole. Glory to God. And in the beginning, Sister Mitchell was what? And the word was?
And the word was God.
And the word. So God and his word are one.
Yeah. One.
You got the word, you got God, right?
Yeah.
Amen. He dwells in his word. He watches over his word to perform it. Amen. Now, we said, glory to God, we would come and give him thanks.
Give him thanks.
Amen. Can we just come now? Hallelujah. And just give him thanks and return the glory unto him. Amen. Hallelujah. For he is great. And he is greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. It's a good thing to give God thanks. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father. We thank you. Hallelujah. We come to give you thanks. Hallelujah. We come to give you thanks. Hallelujah. We come to give you thanks. Thank you, Father. Thank you, hallelujah. Thank you, hallelujah. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your mercy, Father. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your loving kindness. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you. Thank you for our down line. Thank you for our uprising this day. Thank you. We give you thanks. We came to say thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you for the blood of Jesus. Thank you for the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for the weapons, hallelujah, of our warfare. Thank you, Father, for your protection. Thank you, Father God. Thank you. 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 We humble ourselves under your mighty hand, Father. Today, Father, we return the glory unto you. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We declare your glory. Hallelujah. The glory is thine. Hallelujah. The glory is thine. Hallelujah. Thine is the glory. Thine is the glory. Yours is the glory. Father, everything we are and everything we hope to be, hallelujah, is because of your glory, Father God. You get the glory, Father. You get the glory. You get the glory. You get the glory. You get the glory. We give you the glory, hallelujah. We give you the glory. We give you the glory, hallelujah. Glorious, hallelujah. You are glorious, hallelujah. And we thank you and we praise you and we magnify you. We glorify you, hallelujah. Glory be to God. 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 Glory, 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 glory. Glory to God. Glory to God. We thank you, Father. We thank you. Hallelujah. We're not moved by what we see. We're not moved by what we feel. We're moved by what we believe. Hallelujah. And we believe your word. Hallelujah. We believe it's going to be just like you said it in your word. And so we thank you. You always cause us to triumph in Christ. Thank you. You with us are more, hallelujah, than the world against us. And we thank you. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Father. We thank you for your presence. We thank you that you never leave us, nor do you forsake us. You with us always, even unto the end of the world. And we thank you for it. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for your presence. We have gathered, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. And you're in our midst, and we thank you. We thank you. We thank you, sir. We thank you, sir. We thank you, sir, for being here with us. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, if it had not been for you on our side, where would we be? Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Take the glory, Father. Take the glory, Father. Take the glory. Take the glory. Take the glory. Take the glory. Except you build this house, Father, our labor's in vain. Except you keep the city, the watchman waketh but in vain. Thank you, Father. Thank you, hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for deliverance. Hallelujah, for meeting the bread of sorrows. Hallelujah, thank you, hallelujah. For delivering us from the power, hallelujah, the wicked one, and translating us into the kingdom of your dear son. Thank you for your kingdom. Thank you, Father, that your kingdom is within us. Your kingdom. kingdom, Father, is within us, and we thank you for it. We thank you. 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 We thank you, Father. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you, Father. We thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We can cast our burdens on you. Hallelujah. And you'll sustain us. Hallelujah. You'll never suffer the righteous to be moved. And we thank you. Hallelujah. Never. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We give you praise. We return glory to you. As we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. You may be seated. Amen. Thank the Lord. Amen. Thank the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. It's a good thing.
It's a good
thing. Hallelujah. There's a lot of things that's not good. But it's a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord. Hallelujah. And to bless your name, O Lord Most High. Glory to God. Brother Fitz, what scripture was this that you took this from?
Well, actually, I gave the book to the book two definitions. And so I gave the book each.
But what scripture? Because I want to look at that scripture. Glory to God. Are y'all here today?
Amen.
Thank God for another Sunday.
Yes.
Amen. Congratulations to you, Sister Mitch, Nana. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Give you praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Sometimes children say, I wonder how in the world a grandchild got it made like this. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Isn't it a blessing? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It is a blessing. We thank God for being here again today. Amen. Welcome to Sunday morning service. Amen. At the blessing of Abraham Christian Center Global Ministries. Amen. Where Jesus is Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. There's no one for Psalms. And have a test. T-E-S-T. Glory to God.
The one for Psalms is inhabitants. And that's Psalm 33.
Okay, what does it say? In the meanwhile, can you turn with me to Ephesians 2, and we're going to look at verse, glory to God, we'll start at verse 20. Amen. Glory to God. We're still teaching on praise. Amen. We're teaching on praise. Glory to God. Can we go up just a couple more scriptures? Now therefore him both had access to one spirit and to the Father. Amen. Hallelujah. 2:18. Hallelujah. Glory to God. In Ephesians 2:18. Hallelujah. The word declares, for through him we both have access. Amen. We have access. Access, glory to God, access by one spirit unto the Father. One spirit unto the Father. Amen. We have access to that. You know, the scripture said, therefore being justified by faith, Romans 5:1, we have peace with God. And not only that, we have access into this grace wherein we stand. Amen. We have access, hallelujah, by the Spirit of God to the Father. Amen. One Spirit. There ain't no whole bunch of ways, glory to God, to get to the Father. Jesus said, have I been so long with you and you still asking me to show you the Father? He that has seen me has seen the Father. Glory to God. They said, well, show us the way then. He said, I am the way. I am the truth. I am the light. Now, keep in mind, he is the way. The early church, the first century church, was called the people of the way. Glory to God. Because Jesus said, I am the way. I am the what?
The way.
The truth. Now, when we gird our loins about with truth, what is truth? Anybody here know what truth is? Help me, somebody. I know somebody here know what truth is, huh? You did really good. Sanctify them by thy truth. Now, I don't care what you look at, if you don't have the capability to match it with the truth, which is God's word, amen, you just... His word is the truth. He is the truth. And he is the what? Life. The way, the truth, the life. And we have access, glory to God, by one Spirit. Notice that Spirit is capitalized. So it's talking about what? The Holy Spirit? Who gives the Holy Spirit? God. Turn around, give the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit take you, give you access to the Father. Yes. Amen? Yes. Glory to God. Matter of fact, glory to God, Jesus baptizes in the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost then turns around and baptizes us into the body of Christ. Did you ever read, did y'all ever read that before? Baptized by one Spirit into the body of Christ, the Holy Spirit does that. Are you hearing me? He'll never come and glorify himself. He'll take the things of God and he take the things of Jesus and he'll show them to us. He is the Spirit of what? The Spirit of truth. Well, then if the word is truth, then the Holy Spirit is, glory to God, the Spirit of the Word. The Spirit of truth. And what does he do? He leads and guides us into all what?
Truth.
All truth. All truth. Are you hearing me? He leads and guides us into all truth. Now, if you're not afraid, you should pray, Lord, reveal truth to my spirit. Are you here with me? Lord, reveal truth to my spirit. Truth, Lord. Let me see truth. Holy Ghost is the Spirit of truth. Jesus said, I'm the truth. Glory to God. Word is truth. Glory to God. All of them, hallelujah, are truth. And he take, because let me tell you something. The whole purpose of the sacrifice of Jesus Christ was to get us to the Father. We could not, we were helpless, and we could not deal with the Father unless we dealt with him through Jesus Christ. Anytime, glory to God, that God crossed that timeline, glory to God, hallelujah, and entered into the human race without the blood of Jesus being there. Somebody left here. Because there's no way to stand, glory to God, in the presence of a holy God without a sacrifice or being made righteous so that you can stand in there. Now, he chose Moses because he had a purpose for the people, and he allowed Moses to go to the place, glory to God, hallelujah, where he could give him the Ten Commandments and the other laws so that the people could follow him. Now, you know what happened? Somebody else said, oh, we don't have to listen to you. We can go do that ourselves. And they started up there, and it was rumbling, it was thunder, it was smoke, it was vapor, it was fire. And you know what they said? We'll listen to you, Moses. Are you hearing me? Amen?
Amen.
So, to get to the Father, we have to go through Jesus Christ. There is no other way. None. And so Paul says, if any man glory, let him do what? Glory in the cross. Now therefore, you are no more what? Strangers.
And foreigners.
And foreigners. But what?
Fellowships with the saints.
You know what a fellow citizen is? That's the politics of God. That's where we get the word politics from. The English word. You are the politics with the saints. Amen. In other words, to be a fellow citizen means you are under some kind of government. And don't you ever think in your whole life that there's no government in the kingdom of God. Don't ever trick yourself that there's no government. You know, in the, what, 70s, mid-70s, late 80s, the people took their shoes off, put flip-flops on, glory to God, they started walking to church, and they, hallelujah, glory to God, they started calling the pastor, hey, Bob. Hey, Tom, how are you? Glory to God, they just, anything, you know. Yeah, but I mean, some of the old religious stuff was to the extreme, but some of the new stuff was to the extreme just as well. Glory to God, there has to be, glory to God, a government in the house of God. Now, if God comes here and says, all of y'all, here, I'm going to give you a vision, you one. Everybody going to get a vision. And that's what you follow. Just everybody. What do you think would happen? Chaos. It'd be what?
Chaos.
You think there'd be chaos? Why?
No order.
In this scenario, you said you'd give everybody a different.
Do you know what division is? It's two words put together. Diversity of vision. Different visions. That's how division is caused in the body of Christ. Now, whenever the devil seeks to destroy you, he's going to give you something against me.
Right.
I already know that. Amen? That's an old trick. It's nothing new. Say, hey, check him out. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You can do that just like he does it. You can't. I'll tell you that you can. Any day of the week, I can tell you that you can. Amen? And it's not because I'm somebody. Glory to God, I'm just an old dope fiend, man. I'm telling you, glory to God, that God took, cleaned up, hallelujah, and filled with his spirit, saved, and said, hey, go do this. Glory to God. And some of us can remember, man, people leaving out the place in droves. And I say, I'm going too. I'm out. Just stick around. God said, you're going to sit down.
Amen.
And here we are. Amen. Battered, but unbeatable.
Amen.
Glory to you.
Battered, but unbeatable. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You see, earth people don't think like kingdom people think. They don't. Now you try to process a kingdom process with an earthly mind, and you're going to be twisted every single time. Now I'm up here preaching at the wedding chapel. We got a building in Jesus' name. We got a building in Jesus. I'm speaking by faith. Man, I ain't got no building. I mean, in the natural, no manifestation of no building anywhere. But the man is in the back, Bob, is in the back, glory to God, listening to me in the room. Well, guess what Bob did? He say nothing to me. He go rent the wedding chapel out. I said, you did what? We rented it out. I said, why? He said, I heard you say, you got a building. And so when you start talking kingdom principles and start talking faith, glory to God, the carnal mind cannot get it. And even with the Word of God is not something that you can mentally assent to. I mentally assent to that. Glory to God. It's not the way it works, Brother Bazemore. It's spiritually discerned. Hallelujah. Fellow citizen with the saints and of the household of God. Of the household of who?
God.
And the household of God is a household of what? Of faith. It is also the pillar and the ground of what? Truth. There's that word truth again. Glory to God. It's the pillar and the ground of truth. And we establish, glory to God, that the Word of God is truth. Right? Amen. And it's built upon the foundation of the apostles and the prophets. And Jesus Christ, chief cornerstone. Now, the apostles and prophets are not the foundation. That's not what this is saying right here. It's saying through the gifting of Jesus Christ, he is given this gifting for the apostles and the prophets to lay foundation in people's lives. Those ministries carry foundation with them to lay foundation in your life. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. You just have an evangelist in your life. You just gonna jump around, get excited, amen, stay fired up, encouraged and stuff. But when you come with the apostles and the prophets, they are going to lay foundations in your life. And especially when you get to this first one, because they always, if you check this out, the apostles labor in doctrine. Amen. How many know the church has a blueprint?
Amen.
And you can't just go, well, I just think it's a wonderful idea that we do this. I don't think so. Well, what? Because the Word says. Because the Word says. I'm telling you right now, I'm into it. Not into it, but I'm really getting this. The Bible says, I suffer not a woman to usurp authority over a man. So, you a woman, you a bishop, you want to be over the church. What do I do with the scripture? Just because you feel like you want to be a bishop. The Bible says that a woman should not. It showed me any place, glory to God, where this is happening. Hallelujah. And I'll show you, glory to God, hallelujah, a great disturbance. See, people don't understand why the earth is going through the different things that it's going through. There's a reason why, glory to God, fire's just breaking out everywhere. Earthquakes falling, people building falling down. All of this stuff is going on. The earth is upset and trembling because there are reasons for it. And not that I live in it. Of course, the whole earth is groaning for the manifestation of the sons of God. But man, let me tell you something. People twist stuff up. A man, the first man, Adam, his wife, led him into death. The second Adam came and took his bride out of death and gave her life.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? That's just something on the side journey for you. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, I said, alpha what? An alpha female. Who ever heard of such a thing? This get people mad. That's the same thing. If you say you ain't supposed to be gay, if you don't know the difference between a man and a woman, you don't know if you're a man or a woman, and then people say, well, we mad with you. Because, glory to God, what are you mad at me for? If I'm a Bible preacher, what am I supposed to preach?
The Bible. Amen.
They lay foundations in your life. Amen. Their apostolic and prophetic ministry will lay a foundation in your life. How many remember you got the book Developing Your Prophetic Gifting by Graham Cook? Read it. Graham's a church prophet. You gonna find out some church stuff from Graham. You know why? He's a church prophet that functions inside the church. Now you got outhouse stuff and you got in-house stuff. The in-house toilet stink, but boy, that outhouse, Lord have mercy. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He's a in-house prophet, and he has teaching, great teaching, glory to God, on the function of the church. In whom all the building is what?
Fitly framed together.
How many know in Solomon's temple there could be no sound of a hammer or no sound of a chisel? If it don't fit, it don't go there. It just don't go there. Well, you did such and such and such. Why are you going to ask me why? I can tell you. This is why. Fitly framed together. It groweth up into what?
A holy temple.
A holy what?
Holy temple in the Lord.
In where?
The Lord.
Now he's talking about people. He's talking about people fitly joining together and building up a temple for the Lord. What happens in the temple? The presence of God comes to the temple. So he's saying people can get to a place where they fitly join together to one another, and just like the presence of the Lord was in the temple. Isaiah said, man, he was high. And he was lifted up. And his train filled the temple. And there was angels flying around. Hallelujah. They had six wings. With two they covered their face. With two they covered their feet. And with two they did fly. And they were crying, holy, holy, holy. And Isaiah said, wait a minute. I'm a man of unclean lips. And I dwell among a people of unclean lips. And so the Lord took the coal from the altar and put it on his mouth and said, now, go. And so he was a great prophet. He was known as the eagle-eyed prophet because he could see. In whom you also are what?
Built together for
a for what?
Habitation of God through the Spirit.
For what?
A
habitation of God through the Spirit.
What do you do in a habitation?
You reside there.
You live in a habitation, right?
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. So, we are to build a habitation for God. Do not lose your focus about what the primary purpose, glory to God, for coming to church and being a part of church. Everybody, ain't no big eyes and little U's, everybody is here to build a habitation for God through the Spirit of God. Now, what does praise have to do with that? For God inhabits the praises of his people. What does he inhabit?
The praises of the people.
And I want to thank, glory to God, Elder Winters for writing it down of what inhabit means. It means to reside or permanently stay. We don't want to touch. We want him to be here. We want him to be here. We want him to be here. We don't want to have to come here and cast demons out the whole time we're here.
Right.
Not demons in the atmosphere, demons in people. You call me a demon? No. You call me a demon? No. It's not personal. But the devil is the devil. And God is God. You can't separate God from his word. I don't care who you are. I can't do it. You can't do it. Okay? So he's going to reside permanently. He's going to abide, continue, dwell, cause to dwell, make to dwell, a dweller, have habitation, inhabit, lay, place, remain, cause it to remain, and then rest. 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 Glory to God. Hallelujah. Somebody get Psalm 6. Can we go to Psalm 68? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let's go to Psalm 68. Amen. It means to sit down, to dwell, to remain, to settle. It also means marry. What are we? Aren't we the bride of Christ?
Amen.
If you go in the back room and some bride about getting ready, getting married, she want to make sure everything on her is right. Isn't that right? Hallelujah. Then come out with the veil turned around to the side. Glory to God. Hallelujah. One shoe on. Heel broke on the shoe and all of that kind of stuff. Man, that would be worse than killing the president. Glory to God. Heel broke or something go wrong. Are you hearing me?
Yeah.
Something go wrong in the back room where the bride getting ready. No, the bride want everything. Huh? The groom just threw his suit on and just standing there. All right, come on out of here. But the bride nervous is in the service. Get this stuff right. Is everything good? How I look? They got big mirrors back there to make sure everything is perfect. Glory to God. That everything is lined up. Sister Mitchell, don't you believe that when we prepare a habitation for God, that we ought to be exact about it?
Yeah.
Or should we just willy-nilly, arbitrary, just do this any kind of way you think? No. 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 Let God arise and what? You see the habitation, let God come on in the house. Glory to God. And your enemies will be what?
Scattered.
Uh-huh. Glory to God. Let them also that hate him flee before him. As smoke is driven away, so drive them away. As wax melted before fire, so let the wicked perish at the presence of God. At the presence of God. What it mean? What it mean present? He inhabit what? That mean he present in the trip. That means he's present in the praises of his people. And anybody that know, glory to God, that praise will bring the presence of God, they won't be able to stop you from praise. You will be praising in the morning. Praise him in the noonday. Praise him when the sun go down. You'll be habitually praising God. Because of what? Ain't nobody telling you to praise God so that I look like I'm smart because I can teach on praise. I'm telling you to praise God because we want to build a habitation for God right here. Right here, a place where he dwells. A place where his presence dwells. Huh?
Hallelujah.
Did you hear what I said?
Hallelujah.
When I want to hoop, my organ player ain't here. The president. But let the righteous do what?
Be glad.
And let them do what?
Rejoice.
That's exceedingly. God.
Yay! Let them exceeding rejoice.
Yes.
I don't know how you get all this presence of God and ain't doing no rejoicing.
Oh, glory to you.
In the world, can you believe? See, joy and peace are found in believing.
Oh, glory to you, man.
Rejoice! And again, I say, rejoice. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Sing unto the Lord. Sing praises to his name. Extol him who rides upon the heavens by his name. What's his name?
Jah.
Jah. I thought that was the Jamaicans' God. Jah. They be singing about Jah. They said, try Jah love. Glory to God. They got it from the Bible. Glory to God. A father of the fatherless and a judge of widows is God in his holy what?
Habitation.
What?
Yes.
Man, how my time? God, huh? God set it to solitary in families. He bringeth out those which are bound with chains. May the chain break today in the name of Jesus because of the presence of Almighty God. You see, when you bring the presence of Almighty God, when somebody walk into the presence of Almighty God, I don't care what kind of chain you got, it'll break.
Yes.
Ain't no devil going to follow you in the presence of God.
It must flee.
Oh, you are no better than tramp. You've been walking in the devil mess. You no better come track up the presence of God with the devil's mess. Glory to God. My house shall be called a house of prayer of all nations. Glory to God. Hallelujah. God, okay. He said, okay. What? It say, but the rebellious dwell where?
In a dry land.
Mm-hmm. Glory to God. You want to go there? You want to go here?
Nope.
Do this. Get you here. This will get you here. This will get you here. I'm not going to lie to you. I ain't going to hell for telling you no lie. Be rebellious. You're going over here. Are you here with me? Keep going. Oh God, when thou wentest forth before thy people, when thou didst march through the wilderness, say, La, the earth shook, the heavens also dropped. At what?
Presence of God.
Even Sinai itself was moved at the presence of God, the God of Israel. Keep going. Thou, O God, didst send plenty rain, whereby thou didst confirm thine inheritance when it was weary. Thy congregation that dwelt therein, thou, O God, hast prepared of thy goodness for the poor. The Lord gave what?
The word.
And great
was, it?
Was the company of those who published it. You're not here, glory to God, to instruct this house. You are here in this house to get instruction. You are here to get trained so that you can go out and publish the word of God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And I'm going out to publish the word. Go right ahead. Glory to God. Proceed, Governor. Glory to God. To get trained in the word of God. I'll send you pastors after my own heart. They will feed you with knowledge and with instruction. And as you get the instruction, guess what? You go publish it. Hopefully this week you'll be out publishing about the presence of God. About how praise brings the presence of God. You're going to tell people, our church, glory to God, is building up a habitation for God in the spirit.
Glory to you, Father.
A place where God can dwell. No flesh. Ain't no superstar around here. No flesh. No flesh. No flesh. Be seen. Only what? The presence of God. Go to 114. Hallelujah. Great was that, ain't this? Boy. Oh my God. Hallelujah. Go to the Psalms. Psalm 114. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Still talking about praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise builds a habitation, huh, Sister Bishop? Does it bring a habitation? When you start praising God, he pulls up a chair and he becomes an audience. His presence is right there. Glory to God. When you pray, when you praise him, this is what David knew. Glory to God. When Israel went out of Egypt, the house of Jacob from a people of a strange land. You better get away from the folk that talking crazy now. Huh? Job's wife came to him and said, man, why don't you just cuss God and die? Job said, woman, you sound like a fool. You don't even sound like my wife. Huh? People who talk a strange language. Like a dull knife, Jack. They just ain't cut. Talking loud, but ain't saying nothing. Amen. Oh, yeah. Shut up. I don't hear you. You got to come out from the strange language and people that talk real stupid. Lord, walking through there. Shut up, man. Go tell that to somebody else. I don't want to hear about you saw a silhouette of the Lord walking through the room. What good that gonna do me? Well, you deep. No, you ain't deep. You drowning. They came out from among a people that spoke a strange language. And look what happened. Judah, what does Judah mean?
Praise.
Praise became the place where he dwelt. It became the place, glory to God, where his sanctuary was. Where's God's sanctuary at? God's sanctuary is in praise. Glory to God. You want to build a sanctuary, a habitation, a temple, glory to God. Temples come together because God is in us. Every single one. Then when we come together, glory to God, we build a habitation. A bunch of temples come together and make one temple. And Israel, his dominion. What became is the place where God dominates is in the place of submission. Are y'all breathing? Are y'all breathing? In the place of submission, everybody has to submit themselves under the mighty hand of God. Listen, I'm up here preaching, but let me tell you something. When we close them doors, glory to God, we turn the air back up and we get ready to go home. I gotta go out of here and I gotta run for my life. Glory to God. I tell you what, you would not want the fights that I have to fight. I guarantee you don't.
Well, you know, I just messing with this little demon of depression.
What?
That's all you got? You can easily shake that off. Put on the garment of praise.
Hallelujah.
Get rid of that spirit of heaviness. It'll just be gone. Glory to God. You can shout your way. You can shout your way out of that. You can shout your way out of that. You can shout your way. But when the devil, glory to God, is whispering in people's ear, who God, glory to God, has sent, glory to God, to help you, and he whispering, go hurt him. You know, a shepherd in bad shape when the sheep attack him, because sheep don't attack nobody. Oh, there's the shepherd running. What the shepherd running for? The sheep is attacking him. The sheep, what kind of sheep is them? Huh? Let me keep going. There go that shepherd again. What are you doing? Running from them sheep. Them sheep after him again. Glory to God. Damn sheep done turned on him. Sheep. Sheep don't even have no teeth to hurt nobody with. They only can eat grass. But they showing them grass here. Wait, Willie. Hold on, Willie. Glory to God. Slow up, Willie. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I thought Mary had a little lamb. Glory to God. Whoa, that's a big one now. Glory. All right. The seed saw what? It saw that Judah, or praise, was God's sanctuary, and that the submission, glory to God, of God's people, and God was dominating. When the seed saw it, it fled. What did the seed do?
It fled.
What seed you think he talking about here? Come on, y'all know this. Huh? That's all we got to say. Ain't no right or wrong answer. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You get a wrong answer, we correct you. That's all. That's what happens in the house of God. You get corrected, right? Amen. Include me. Anybody don't want correction, tell God. Hallelujah. Only a fool despises correction. Only a fool despises correction. All scripture is given by the inspiration of God and is profitable. It's profitable for reproof, correction, instruction. That's why you profit getting corrected. Why? Because he put you open to a profitable place that if you in that place, you won't be profitable. Oh my God. You could just look now and say, No. The word is profiting. It's being mixed with faith. When the sea saw the presence, when the sea saw that praise was God's sanctuary, and that submission was the place where he dominated, it fled. Jordan was driven back. They went across two bodies of water. They went across the Red Sea. Anybody know what the Red Sea represents? Sister Mitchell, I know you know this. Red Sea is baptism. They got baptized in the cloud, coming down through there. What does the Jordan represent? Being filled with the Holy Ghost. Amen. You got two bodies of water to cross. You got the glory to God. You got to come out the world. Come out from among them and be ye separate, said the Lord.
and touch not the unclean thing. Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. We made a discovery. You know what it is? It's a way to get saved. You want me to tell you? You got to run over to Denny's and run back over here and run over to Denny's. You got to do this 5 times now, and that'll get you saved.
Wait a minute now. How you go get some new stuff about how to get saved when you got the word of God says that if you confess that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart God raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. You didn't come up with nothing new. God ain't gave you anything new. Glory to God, we are complete in him.
Are you hearing me? We are complete in him. Complete in him. That Jordan was there. The mountains skipped like rams and the little hills like what? Lambs. Oh, somebody start asking the question around here. What the hell? What's wrong with you? What the hell are you? What the hell are you? Maybe that was a southern person asking that. What the hell are you? What ailed thee, O thou sea, that thou fled? What was wrong with you, thou Jordan, that thou was driven back? What was wrong with y'all? Huh? Ye mountain that you skip like ram, and you little hills like lamb. What's wrong out there? What the matter? Tremble thou, earth, at the what?
The presence of the Lord.
Oh, you see, when you get the presence of the Lord, glory to God, he'll part the seas in your life. He'll part the rivers in your life. He'll bring the mountains down out of your life. Glory to God. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. The problem, glory to God, the problem is not a problem anymore because God's got it now. Who got it? God has it now. Glory to God. Problem, pro, blim. In favor of what? The answer. Glory to God. I found the answer. Glory to God. And I lift my hands and yada pray because the answer, glory to God, is not in my head. It's above my head. Ain't nothing I could do with that sea. Ain't nothing I could do with that river. Ain't nothing I could do with them mountains or them hills on my own. I need somebody. Ooh, I need somebody to help me. Glory to God. And all of a sudden, glory to God, Judah, his praise people, glory to God, brought him a sanctuary. Glory to God, his submissive people gave him dominion. Glory to God, because they submitted to his will, submitted to his purpose. Glory to God, that sea just took off. And he made Pharaoh and them chariot. Can you imagine? You ride the chariot with horses and you can't catch some people on their feet? Not if they make your wheels square. Chariots start slide. They say, all of Israel through, all them people who made praise their sanctuary and submission, are they all through? Yeah, all 3 million of them have made it through. Okay, they enemies is out there with square ties on. Glory to God, running behind them, can't catch them. Whoa! They got a good bath out there. Only different word, they didn't recover from the bath. Hallelujah, they wasn't rubber-dub-dubbing. Glory. They didn't come out of there. To me, told Moses, he said, you take a good look at them because you not gonna see them anymore. Go with me to Joshua 6. I'm telling you, praise is good in trouble. Did you hear what I said? Did you hear what I said? I can't wait till young people in here throwing it up for the Lord. You know what I'm saying? Throw it up, throw it up, throw it up. Glory to God, praising him. Let's go down to about verse 15. I'm going to show you what praise will do. Glory to God. Hallelujah. When God inhabited the praise of his people, boy, some stuff started happening. Glory to God. And it came to pass on the seventh day that they rose early about the dawning of the day and compassed the city after the same manner seven times. Only on that day they compassed the city seven times, because it's the seventh day. On the seventh day, you go around seven times. The other 6 days, you go around once. Okay, let's keep going. And it came to pass at the seventh time when the priest blew the trumpet. I got me a shofar. I just got to learn how to play it. I've been working. You got to, because you got to get your lip a certain way to play that shofar. You can't just blow in it. If you just blow in it, just air come out. You don't want air to go out to God. We've been blowing hot air to God long enough. We there's hot air, glory to God. You're full of hot air, buddy. Glory to God. Not none of y'all. Glory to God. And again, when the priest blew the trumpet, Joshua said unto the people, shout, for the Lord has given you the city. Shout, for the Lord has given you the city. Shout. Why? Because the Lord, not you, the Lord. These people out here, do you know what their wall was like? You could line up six chariots across it with horses. I'm talking about a team of them. Six chariots across on that wall. That's how thick that wall was. Glory to God. But we're going to see something about this wall. Glory to God. You see this? It say, and they did what? They shout. Shout. Anybody know what shout is? They said, what you shouting about? Because the Lord
has given
you the city. And so the priest blew the trumpet and the people started